So one thing is that there's subtleties that are embedded in the mindfulness practices and other practices that if we tease apart, even if just for the sake of having a conceptual read on what we're exploring when we practice, that can be helpful, I think, in many ways. So one aspect is relaxation and the calm. And so many are looking to practices for that, and they can be useful for that, but also it can be a part of something bigger than the calm itself. Might you speak to that in the ways that resonate with you?
Absolutely. So I think a lot of times people misunderstand that they think that mindfulness is about being relaxed. And when they start practicing and they notice how busy their mind is and how many emotions and thoughts and sensations arise, they feel like they're doing it wrong. Mindfulness is a way of being and relating to life as it arises. And that includes the messiness, that includes the challenge, the pain, the difficulty. It's not about relaxation, although relaxation is often a wonderful side effect, because as we learn how to be more resilient and how to meet life and meet the challenges, we do tend to have this kind of residual ease or calm. But it's certainly not not how it's supposed to feel moment by moment, and it's certainly not the goal. The goal of mindfulness actually is to see clearly. That's what the word means. And we want to see clearly so we can respond effectively, so that we can respond to life as it arises, whatever arises.